Hey guys, welcome to Tots and Moms. My name is Kavita and today we are talking about dry fruits, when it can be offered to babies, in what quantity and in what method, and things to be kept in mind while offering dry fruits to babies and kids. So let's get started understanding dry fruits benefits. But before that, dry fruits are fruits that are dehydrated. All the water content is taken out by either drying them under sun or by using specialized dehydrators. Just a common knowledge. And dry fruits in general are considered to be highly nutritious. The benefits are they are good for immunity and weight gain in general. We all know when there is a weakness, doctor advises go and eat some dry fruits regularly. So this is one thing which is common, but it is ideal for people or kids who are anemic. It's ideal to improve digestion. It also is good for bone health, eye health, building good muscles. It also is good for keeping babies energized for a long time. Now we know growing children are on their toes. They want to learn and keep learning, and there is no end for their learning, right? So they need that energy, and dry fruits are ideal to be included in their diet. And from 8 months only it can be started. Now how and other details I'll tell you, but before that, two varieties of dry fruits are there. I wanted to segment this because I'm talking specially about babies and kids. One is soft dry fruits, softer ones like raisins, all sort of berries, what else, apricot, figs. These come under soft dry fruits. Hard dry fruits, almond, pista, walnuts, pecans, cashew nuts, there are plenty of them, which are harder to be eaten by babies or kids. Now let's talk about multiple ways of how it can be included in their diet. Yeah, the ways it can be included, at first, softer dried fruits. If you have followed baby led weaning from 6 months, if your baby is learning to eat on their own, be it porridges, soft foods, then you can ideally give it to them by just smashing it with your fingers, the raisins. You can just give a good beat on dates and cut it vertically so that they hold it well and eat it. The dates and even figs, that way you can offer to them. And if your baby is not yet chewing at 8 months, don't worry, 10, 12, 14 months, at that time you can start following this method. Then soft dry fruits, traditional method, you can soak it in water, you can make a puree out of it and offer in few quantities, a little quantities, and a few spoons of it is what I meant when I used few. And you can even mix it with porridges. Like you're making any porridge, then few spoons of it. I have made a video on dry fruit sauce recipe, how to make it. So please watch that, it will be helpful. You can make it and store it and then use it whenever you are offering porridges. You can just add a spoonful of it and give to your child. The third method, we'll talk about harder dry fruits, almond, pista, how to give it. For babies, yes, it is very difficult due to choking hazard. So in the powder form, you can offer it. You can even soak it and blend it with purees, that's another way. But I have made a recipe on how to make almond and dates powder, how to make dry fruits powder, mixing all dry fruits like pista, almond, cashew nuts and walnuts. Do watch that video. In case you find it difficult, you are running out of time, or you just want to buy it and use it, don't worry, there is no particular reason that you are busy or anything. There's no hesitation when you are buying something from outside for your baby. It's absolutely fine. Our products are USDA certified and FSI certified. Since 7 years we are selling, and this has always been the best seller. And you can buy it from Amazon, Flipkart, FirstCry, Meesho, Big Basket. All big e-commerce sites, our products are available. And dry fruit powders sells well all the time. The final way, according to my ideas, I'm including all these. For toddlers who are ready to chew, who can easily chew even the hard dry fruit, you can give it to them, roast it and give it to them. Add a little salt or a little spice and give it to them. Or you can add honey after roasting it. These are simple ways, and you can add it to their kheer. If you're making any dessert, just roast it in ghee and cut it. I mean, you will cut it and then roast it in ghee and add it to those kheer and other sort of desserts that you make, barfi, laddu, anything. And murmura or anything that you're making, even there you can add. These are ideal ways of including it in smaller quantity, because we cannot have murmura or I'm not getting the right word. It is made out of rice. It is a puffed rice. Yes. So that puffed rice, when you make a savory version, then you can add it in small quantities. Those are the ideal ways of eating dry fruits in moderate quantities. Okay, so this is one. You can make milkshakes using that. You can soak it and offer it to them regularly. These are the ideal ways. Two things at the end I would want to mention. At first, see, we all know that these are helpful in weight gain and boosting immunity. So it doesn't mean we give it in a very, very good quantity. You have to include it in moderation, and variety is the key. Not that every day same soaked almonds we will give. We will have to give nuts, all sort of nuts like walnut, pista, keep changing it. Even raisins, apricots, keep changing. Variety and moderation are the best keys to keep in mind, because these are heavy foods and can be difficult to digest. Indigestion, constipation, you don't want such issues to happen. Even healthy food to be given in smaller quantities only. Now, next one, few of them worry about allergy. It is not a major concern, because research says that before 1 year, even in my last video where I was talking about eggs, before 1 year when you offer these foods, it is going to be easy for them to digest. It would not cause any issues. At least it would reduce the percentage of concerns that it may cause. Even if you feel there is a family history, talk to your doctor. He may recommend you to offer it in this way only. So another thing you'll have to keep in mind while you're introducing anything that is new and you're worried about allergy or any issues, even digestion issues, give it in the morning. Observe the child for the day. If you see any different symptom or anything that is worrying you, you can go to the hospital, because reactions start after 4-5 hours of it, no? So these are certain things that I wanted to mention. I really hope that you liked the video. I really guess that I have included all the points that one parent has in mind while introducing dry fruits to one's child. If I have left out anything, please drop a comment. Me and my team would be happy to answer that for you. And do consider checking our dry fruit powder. It is really one of the best food that you can buy from our store. Thank you so much for watching this video. I'll see you soon in yet another one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.